children. This time I'm coming to you from my craft room, and I'm hoping that no tiny children will run in and start trying to talk to me during the video. Well, the purpose of this video is to give you guys some detail on an upcoming art contest that I would invite you all to join in participating. And what they are doing is holding this contest called Wrap the Utility Box. I don't know if you've ever noticed when you've been driving around at like major intersections, off to the side of usually one of the corners, you're gonna see a rather large metal box. These can have all the power and the control for the lights, the signals, etc. They're necessary, but they're really ugly and unsightly, and what they would like to do is make them look a lot cooler by taking your art and placing it all around the utility box. But it's going to be kind of like how they do billboards, where they'll enlarge it and they'll print it, and then they'll actually get it glued on to the utility box. So it's a great opportunity for you to have your artwork displayed around the city. I'm allowed to send in 10 submissions from our school. Probably a pretty good chance of getting one of y'all's chosen. Maybe more than one person, who knows? So here are the details that you need to know for this. They want you to submit your artwork on a sheet of white copy paper like this. Draw with on your paper like this landscape. I'm going to show you some images of three utility boxes that have been wrapped. These are not from Longview, but I want to show you some of the things that the artists did, and they did really well. First of all, my favorite one is the very first one that has the teal background. I like what the artist did here for several reasons. Number one, they chose the animal, and I don't know why they chose an animal, but they did. So you can choose any object you would like to do. The second thing is they made it interesting. They almost overlaying one another, and it draws your eye in. So make it interesting if you're doing an object or an animal or, you know, something from everyday life. That they chose colors that were contrasting colors, and so if you remember, if you look at a color wheel, when you are using one color, you can find its complementary color on the exact opposite side. So this artist chose that amazing teal blue background, and then they chose for the nose a color that would really help that, would really pop out of that teal. I want you to think about like how you can make it bright and bold and stand out. And the fourth thing I wanted to point out is that everything is outlined. I want you to outline everything that's in pencil in a dark color so that it pops. You can use, you know, a black marker, a black pen. If you don't have a Sharpie or a thin marker, that would work great. Use your entire space of your paper. I like the first one a whole lot better because they were able to do it multiple times and it looked really good wrapped around the box. You didn't have to see the whole utility box to get the image that the artist drew, which I think is a really great idea. Make sure that it's, the colors that you pick are bold and bright because you want it to be something really cool looking that catches your eye as you're driving by. Now, the flyer that is attached here says that they need the submissions in by June 1st. I'm going to leave an envelope or like a file folder at the front office of the school so that when you are finished, you can actually drop your paper copies off. You can scan them and email them to me. They have to be high resolution though, and so only your parents would know if your scanner is a high res scanner. You can't take a photo of it with your iPhone and email it to me like you've been doing for some of your class assignments. So you can either drop it off at school or you can scan it and email it to me. I would like those done by May 25th. So May 25th, May 25th, May 25th, and I have to pick 10 out of all the ones that I get, and hopefully you guys are going to come up with some great ones, and it's going to be really hard for me to choose. Make sure you have something interesting, bold, bright colors. appropriately here. And I cannot wait to see what it looks like when we have multiple people wrapping the utility box. So I hope you guys have a great day, and happy Friday's Eve. And I can't wait to see y'all soon. Talk to you later, guys. Bye. Today's Crazy Hair Don't Care Day, and I have no idea what day that is, but hello, tiny children, or you need to, whenever, I don't know. Coming to you live from my craft room. That didn't work. Which just means a room full of junk. This time coming to you from the bottom of my closet. Yeah, that's what it means. Anyways.